Hello everybody and welcome to the Realm of Myths. My name is Phaethodas and here we have one more new fashion build. You know, in the past we have seen about 3 or 4 other fashion builds. Here we have one more, which is a new one. This one is the dark build, and the idea behind this build was is to have items that make our character look a bit dark. Or you could say black, because yeah, these items are a bit black. But anyway, black, dark, I think in this specific case in the game it is the same thing. I mean, how can you have something that looks dark and at the same time it doesn't look black in this game specifically? I don't know. So here we have it. I decided to go with the Sword of Eternal Darkness because this is the dark build. So yeah, the Eternal Darkness. And I decided to go dual wielding this one because it makes it look very cool. And you can see that this sword is very long. Very, very long as a sword. So it feels very awesome. It feels very nice doing battle by using these two swords. Very long swords. So here we have it. This is the build. I decided to go with Cedric Worker, which is a Dream Mastery, a Rune Mastery. In Dream Mastery, I have maxed out skills. I'm using Trance of Wrath. I have maxed out all of these skills. Here we have maxed out the Distortion of Fate because of, you know, resistances and survivability. Here we have Phantom Strike, Dream Stealer. And in Rune Mastery, I'm maxed out this one. Maxing out these two skills. This one has a point. These two have 1 point. This one is maxed out because this is a dual wielder skill. This skill is a dual wielder skill. And it makes sense to max out this one. I have spent some points here to be able to get some more armor and protection because, truth be told, the resistances, the survivability of this build is not very good. And here we have maxed out this one. This is the build for now in Legendary, level 66, Legendary difficulty. Offensive ability is perfect. Defensive ability is very, very good for the whole Legendary difficulty. Casting speed, movement speed are very good. Here we have secondary resistances that are they are good enough, I could say. Let's say that they are good. But the main problem is here. Minus 44, minus 48, minus 8, minus 22, 18, minus 95, minus 100. 22. This is actually a hybrid build. I have spent some points only on strength. I get many points because I have items that provide strength attributes. I have spent most of my points to intelligence and dexterity. Almost equal amount of points on dexterity and intelligence, but I get intelligence because both Dream Mastery provides intelligence and Rune Mastery provides intelligence. So yeah, we get some intelligence. So now for the items. We have the Glory Bringer, very nice artifact. It helps very much with all of the stats. We have the Myrmidon's Cheat, and this is a Master Infrequent item. We have the Hag's Skin on this one to get resistances. We have the Sword of Eternal Darkness, of course, 2 times. Here I decided to go with this Mark of Faris, which is an upgraded one. It comes with the Juggernaut prefix. And I think it is Immortality suffix. And it is a very, very nice one. It helps with both damage output and, of course, lots of survivability. Here we have the Cup of Ford. This one is a very good item and it helps very much this build, of course. It also provides the Death Ward, which is a very nice skill to have because it helps you when your life is going down and you are very close to getting killed. This one triggers and it saves your life. Here we have the Hell Spiral Ring of the Owl. Very, very nice item. It provides lots of damage output and survivability with the 9% health. Our health points are good enough for Legendary difficulty. Of course, the more you have, the better, but this is good enough. The resistances is the problem, not health points. Here we have the Mill Quartz Works. This is an item that came to the game with Atlantis DLC. It is a great item, I mean 50% physical damage. And at the same time, plus 19% strength at 96 strength. This is very OP when it comes to physical damage builds. Here we have the Crimson Gem of Sitorius. This one is very good. I got it this one for the health points, strength points, defensive ability, and total damage is very good. And here we have the Pillars of Karnus. Okay, look, guys, the point of this build, the fashion build, is to put together a build which looks great as fashion. It is all about the visual appearance. It is not about the performance of the build. We get items, we try to put together very, very good looking bits based on how items look together and not based on how good the builds will be. So, in a way, these fashion builds of mine are challenging builds, because you put together fashion builds and then you try to go through legendary and see if the fashion builds are good enough. If they can win the fashion contest, whatever, you know, fashion. This is the average damage, the attack speed is not very good, and damage DPS. You trigger this one, you trigger this one, you trigger this one. Resistance is, it goes up to 70%, this is goes up to minus 61, because this one provides both bleeding and vitality damage resistances. This one doesn't provide any resistances, but it's very, very powerful, very, very good. And of course, all of my resistances are totally messed up, except for vitality, which is almost perfect. Now, let's go kill a couple of enemies, so that you can see how this build runs in the map and how you kill enemies. Where are the enemies hiding? Okay, you want to open up the chest. The good thing, look, the average damage is not very good, but since we use the rune weapon, which increases many types of all types of damage in a way, then this one goes up. I will hit some enemies and you will see how up it will go. Okay, 3000. These enemies are not good enough to withstand many hits of mine and to see how high rune weapon can go. Yeah, it goes about 3300 DPS. But it doesn't really matter, because we have some powerful skills here. You know, in this game, when you have skills that reduce resistances of enemies, and then you hit your enemies after they get the resistances reduced, you kill them faster because you deal now much more damage. So, in a way, skills like this one with reduced resistances to enemies are multipliers to your average damage, which means that you deal actually more damage than what the average damage the character sheet shows. Okay, let's go kill some spiders. We also have the slam skill, which is amazing. It can stun enemies. It also deals a very good amount of damage. Of course, this slam skill initially belongs to Warfare Master, which I'm not using, but I get it from an item. And when you get skills from items, they are not as powerful as the skills when they come from Masteries. But many times they are good enough to help you, you know, as a supplementary type of a skill for damage output or something like that. So, this is the build, guys. The gameplay is what you see here. It is very, very simple. You use these skills here, three attacking skills, very powerful skills, all three of these. You use this one all the time to get more stun resistance, physical and piercing bleeding absorption. And you attack enemies and you kill enemies, many enemies. Of course, so far this one has 0 total deaths in legendary difficulty. But it is not like this build cannot get... This build will get killed maybe even many times, unless I will be very careful throughout the whole legendary campaign. We will see, I don't know. You know, it is all about being careful in this game and also getting resistances, which are very bad for this build. This go, yeah. So guys, this is the build. I don't know if you like the dark build, fashion build. I like very much how it looks like. And this weapon here is awesome, at least visually. The stats also are very good of the weapon, but this is not the best weapon in the game, I would say. But yeah, it looks awesome and it is a perfect fit, I would say, with the rest of the items that look altogether great, very great. This is the dark build. I don't know, guys, if you like what you see. If you like this build, let me know your opinion in the comments below. Write a comment and say whatever you want to say about the game, about the life, about, I don't know, your dreams, whatever. And I will see you very soon with many more Titan Quest videos and other videos of other games. And of course, live streams. So, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you like what you see to stay updated with much more content that is always coming in this channel. And I'll see you very, very soon again. Also, stay healthy and play Titan Quest.